Yes, I know. Weird. But you know what? Just get in line and suck me. It's Wednesday. AEW is coming on tonight. So, why don't I? I mean, of course, you probably new ones out there. And pretty much if you've been watching me already, I have spoken on what I meant about AEW. And I'm most likely going to bury this show tonight. Just give you a warning. You know, I'm not going to, pretty much not going to like it, so might as well just skippity-doo right on out. And you should know how AEW likes to preach. It is Wednesday, and you know what that means. So right off the bat, to kick the show off, you know, Chris Jericho comes out and, you know, he's there to, as you know, just from last week, is to talk some sense into Garcia. You know, of course, you know, I've been watching it in the background. You know, if you've been paying attention, you know, I got you. If you haven't, or, you know, no matter. But, you know, it's been stemming from last week of what happened between the match from Garcia and Bryan, and, you know, basically Garcia being conflicted by Jericho and Daniel Bryan, kind of like, you know, angel in a you know, demon on your shoulder, hanging over your shoulder. So obviously Jericho is trying to, you know, talk him to keep Garcia on, you know, the dark side basically, and he's trying to reassure him of, you know, not basically, you know, going babyface and turning left. And, you know, he wants him to apologize to himself, Jericho. He wants Garcia. And Garcia is, like, you know, being conflicted and all. You know, he talks about how that was his, it was his dream match, basically. He was in there with his hero. He said that, you know, he didn't care if, you know, whether or not if he was regarded as a wrestler or a sports entertainer. He just cared about that match between himself and Bryan, and he said that Jericho ruined it. And of course, you know, Jericho was not trying to hear it. You know how deep it twisted Jericho gets. You know, he's still trying to reassure and keep him on the sports entertainer part of the Appreciation Society. You know, a sports entertainer. And of course, yeah, Bryan comes out and, you know, basically it's like even more, now more of a confliction. You know, you got the angel and then you got the demon. Jericho the demon and Bryan is the angel, and they got both of him on both of his shoulder, basically in his ear, telling him to pick a side. I mean, Bryan, he's like said the same thing basically. If I'm not gonna try to tell you what to do, you know, you're a wrestler. But I have to say, that statement right there, he's, you know, basically the same as Jericho, just trying to get him to join, you know, side and conflict him. And, you know, Garcia can't take it anymore. You know, he leaves, and, by being so conflicted so much, and, you know, he's not going to, basically, you know, because he's still, I don't know, I could be gearing towards, and, you know, whatever you could basically see as that is. And that, when Bryan says, yeah, that, you know, that's entertaining right there. You know, that pisses, that unravels Jericho. And he said, you know what pisses me off, Bryan? You know, people keep saying you're the best wrestler in the world today. And I've been around, yeah, basically for the amount of years that he's been around. You know, he's trained with the best. You know, he's been with the hearts. He's done it all. You know, it's basically saying he's a better student. He knows much more inside the ring than Bryan will ever will know. And they make the match, you know, obviously they come to, you know, obviously you saw it coming that, yeah, so they're basically gonna be facing it all out, you know, September 4th. And yeah, he's like, I feel like it's that, I heard of like a reference line, that first line, it reminded me of Roddy Piper when he had said that to Bret Hart, you know, leading up to their WrestleMania. And of course, as soon as he said that, he knew what was happening next. Even as he was backing away, attack, laid a punch, sucker punches on Daniel Bryan, and yeah, the rest is speaks for itself.
That was a really good segment. Yeah, that was a really good segment. But one thing, because of Daniel Garcia obviously being conflicted and deciding what's gonna happen between both teams also as well, and what he's gonna do, whether obviously what he's gonna choose, between who he's gonna choose, and what path is he gonna define. What path is he gonna define for himself? And yeah, that's another thing. And just for the history battle between Jericho and Bryan, I like that. I know Daniel Bryan, when he was trained by Shawn Michaels, maybe he was trained by the Hearts too. A lot of wrestlers that y'all know about, a lot of modern wrestlers today was trained by the Hearts. Yeah, Hearts are really like the greatest family, wrestling family of all time. But yeah, I like that line too, like I just mentioned, of when Jericho was I don't know about y'all, but yeah, it felt like a reference to me. Like it reminded me of Roddy Piper and Bret Hart, the whole feud between them. But yeah, I guess I'm kind of, yeah, I'm down for that. Jericho and Bryant, yeah, I can dig it. I'll pull in, I'll be along for the ride. But yeah, this I liked that segment, especially with Daniel Garcia, because it showed, if I didn't see it already, that segment showed me, and that showed the potentiability in Daniel Garcia as a wrestler, as a character, and everything in between. So yeah, I enjoyed that.
Unfortunately, moments like that can't last forever. Or at least AEW is stubborn, so because we get our first match, 20 minutes, good gosh, you know how the marks like it. And it's between Jay Lethal. I don't think I ever saw him before. Yeah, in general, but yeah, this is basically, I believe that this is his first match on I guess, me seeing him personally on D Dynamite.
That was what that was, because after the match you had like the team of Swerve and Keith Lee, I guess, with the Acclaim. I guess they had attacked Billy Gunn again, and I guess they had, yeah, they saved that. And I guess that, I don't know, they looks like they might be facing, from what if I'm guessing. I haven't been watching, so but yeah. Oh yeah. Unfortunately, when it comes to the stuff like that, matches, I can care less, because unless there's really anything going into it, I'm not just gonna kick back. I'm not just gonna kick back and take it all in and watch such a just a run-of-the-mill long, lengthy, boring wrestling match. Like, I'm not gonna do that, especially because the state that wrestling is in. And everybody knows how to wrestle. It's 2022 now. It's not like how it was like 30, 40. Everybody can wrestle, from Sasha Banks to Kevin Owens and Kenny Fagboy or whatever. And so yeah, I'm not gonna be blown away, obviously, by matches. I've seen my fair share. I could care less. And yeah, Jay Lethal and Dax Hardwood. And I guess they showed something else also. It looked like a team, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. Probably like another team, or a new set of indie, if indie fed marks coming to AEW. So yeah, I could care less though.
So then we cut to Thunder Rosa, and it's like a interview basically turns into a breaking news. She's injured, and yeah, I don't know if this is a storyline injury or what, but yeah, she's injured, and she won't be able to defend it right now. So I guess where there's going to be a interim as well at All Out, and she wishes that Tony wins it, and more so else that goes on, just like. everything else involving AEW, I haven't, it's been a backpedal for me. Like, I haven't cared about the women's division in AEW since, the last time I talked about it. Yeah, you see this right. They're doing the unification match now, and I pretty got glimpses of that, from last week. And yeah, not surprising coming from AEW. Wow. Just wow. Oh, wow. What a horrendously put together match. You know, even though I'm a bit pissed right now seeing what I just saw moments ago, yeah, I will talk about this though, because it did, it's Christian, and I love Christian. Yeah, so it looks like Christian, he's finished. He's trying to reason, or just try. I guess they're trying to more so manipulate him to get him to apologize, and correct the mistakes that he did. Whether it's from the title losing the titles, or saying the stuff that he said about him, and trying to injure him. Yeah, I'm ready for this match. It's one of the most one of the few things that I found entertaining and liked coming from AEW. So I'm excited for this.
If you were coming here, to find me surprised by what AEW, just ironically, just moronically did with Moxley and Punk, like how can you be surprised? Like I've said this numerous times, like how can you be surprised? It's what AEW does. They come up with shortcomings. That's what they do. They don't have anything compelling to tell, because Tony Khan himself is an utter childish cokehead. He's a complete and full-on mark. He doesn't have a fucking clue to what Esu should do in a match like this. Hey, I'm obviously not a Punk fan. Think he's a fag. It's pretty obvious. But, like, a match like this, Moxley and CM Punk, and you're putting it, not even, at the main event at least. It's in a quarter in the show, and it's a squash match, and this is a unification match. It's a unification match, and you pull this. I've heard the reports already. Of course, we had the reports. I even talked about it. CM Punk having issues now when he did that Adam Page promo. And there's reports, even though it's rumors, but it's something to take into account. CM Punk, he might be leaving. Is CM Punk going to leave AEW? Is he going to quit? Because they had reports of that also backstage, that he wasn't even going to show up at Dynamite. Growing frustration from the last time that he had faced Adam Page, was with that Double or Nothing. He's had a problem with, because it's pretty, he's had a problem with AEW's been doing right now. And just look at the backstage. Just look at what Tony is doing. He has no brain. And people want to compare him? Are you serious? The fact that it's even talks of Tony Khan being compared to Paul Heyman. I'm going to keep it right there. I might talk about that in the future, but I'm just going to keep it right there. Fucking nonsensical. And you have shit like this. The man doesn't know how to book a story. Even if it was told, he was tucked in bed and his mommy told, or his daddy told him what a story is, he still wouldn't have a clue. It was, because he smoked and snorted so much coke. probably got pegged too many times by the indies that he doesn't know. He don't like how he doesn't like if y'all haven't heard or seen yourselves, know by now that of course he's gonna fumble. You know, he's done it before in the past with, you know, CM Punk. Just CM Punk as in general, but in just many matches before. I'll ask y'all that question. Like, are you really surprised right now? Are you? Because, come on, it's the AEW. You know, they love, you know, it's great that they have, that you get to the point, but it's been one too many times. Like, you have to, why do you think WWE, when it comes to moments, they have so many moments in history, especially when it comes to waiting for the right moment and catching people by surprise. Like, oh man, they turned a unification match into a squash match. And this is their main event, you know, this is their, like, their main event quality. This is their main championship, folks. And they turned it into a squash match. You know, that's why he's having issues backstage. But like I said, can you really be surprised at, you know, the idiocy and just the lack of knowledge and what to do when it comes to the booking and the storytelling just as a whole? So yeah, I know I haven't talked also about it, but you know, this is why they're going through what they're going through right now, especially with the TV deals, because it's even talked about that they might lose that. And that's even inevitable because it's not like they're improving. But yeah, there you go. Jon Moxley is your undisputed champion. I don't know if this is probably playing into a story, because I've heard reports also, of course, it's been nonstop with MJF. Is he coming back? You know, having to do with CM Punk also as well. So maybe this is the starting point for that. I mean, looks stupid already. I couldn't care. But, you know, wow. What a really horrendously done, like, that moment. Like, just what a horrendously done move right there. Like, that's just makes no sense whatsoever. But it's AEW.